स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू GYS। हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू आर डूइंग वेल। सो एज यू नो, ऑन आवर चैनल वी आर कवरिंग द सिलेबस ऑफ UPSC सिविल सर्विसेज, एंड इन दैट सिलेबस वी आर कवरिंग द एनवायरनमेंट पोर्शन। सो द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन ऑफ टुडे इज द मेथड्स, द इनिशिएटिव्स दैट वी इन इंडिया वी अडॉप्ट फॉर द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ वाइल्ड लाइफ। सो हम भारत में वन्य जीवन कैसे संरक्षित करते हैं, इसके बारे में आज हम डिस्कस करेंगे। हाउ डू वी प्रोटेक्ट द वाइल्ड लाइफ इन इंडिया? सी फ्रेंड्स, आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड यू प्रोटेक्टेड एरिया नेटवर्क इन माई प्रीवियस लेक्चर। इफ़ यू हैवंट सीन माई वीडियो, प्रीवियस वीडियो, यू आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू गो इन टू द प्ले लिस्ट एंड प्लीज सर्च फॉर इट एंड सी इट। इन दैट आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू द प्रोटेक्टेड एरिया नेटवर्क। सो बेसिकली इन द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ वाइल्ड लाइफ वी अडोप्ट मल्टीपल स्ट्रेटजीज। सो अमंग दीज मल्टीपल स्ट्रेटजीज वन स्ट्रेटजी ऑफ डिक्लेयरिंग अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया एज प्रोटेक्टेड एरिया नेटवर्क। वट इज अ प्रोटेक्टेड एरिया नेटवर्क? आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड यू, आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अगेन इन नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। सी नाउ, इन दैट प्रोटेक्टेड एरिया नेटवर्क वी फॉलो टू स्ट्रेटजीज, दैट इज नेशनल इनिशिएटिव्स एंड ग्लोबल इनिशिएटिव्स। These protected areas are declared at national level as well as global level. So in today's lecture, we will be going to cover the national initiatives. So what is the focus of today? The focus of today is the national initiatives, that is national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, conservation reserves and community reserves. See, first of all, before telling you what is protected area network, you must know about the biodiversity. Friends, you might have heard about biodiversity. Biodiversity is nothing but it generally refers to the variety and variability of life on earth. Any kind of life that is on earth comes under the definition of biodiversity. See, you all know that in today's developing world, all this biodiversity is under consistent threat due to anthropogenic activities, due to human activities. For the purpose of conserving it, the nation states across the world are taking various initiatives. See, we as human beings are dependent upon this biodiversity. We continuously exchange our resources with this biodiversity. For the purpose of our sustainable development, we must conserve it. See, so for that purpose, we declare certain areas of very high ecological importance from the viewpoint of biodiversity as protected areas. So friends, protected area is nothing but it is a location which receives protection because of its recognized natural, ecological or cultural value. So if a particular region has immense natural importance or ecological importance, or if it has immense biodiversity which is very important for the survival of human being as well, then it is declared as protected area and it is conserved. So these areas can be national parks. Protected areas are of multiple types. They can be national parks, they can be wildlife sanctuaries, they can be conservation reserves, they can be community reserves, they can be biosphere reserves, extra. So in today's lecture, our main focus is on protected areas in India. What are the protected areas in India? What type of strategy we adopt for conserving the wild fauna and flora? So in India, in our national initiative, we also declare protected areas. India also follows the approach of protecting habitats and wild fauna and flora by declaring certain regions as protected areas. See, we declare these protected areas under a legislation. We have a full-fledged legislation for declaring areas as protected areas, and this legislation is important from your prelims point of view, that is Wildlife Protection Act. So this Wildlife Protection Act governs the mechanism by which we declare the protected areas in different regions. See, currently India has 4.92% of its area under the protected area regime. So we in India have four type of protected areas that enjoy legal backing, that is that they enjoy the legal backing of Wildlife Protection Act. So these are national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, conservation reserves and community reserves. See earlier only there were only two types of protected areas under Wildlife Protection Act, that is national parks and wildlife sanctuary. But by the amendment of 2003, when we amended the act in 2003, the Wildlife Protection Act 1972, two further categories were included, that is conservation reserves and community reserves. Now four type of protected areas are declared under Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So the main points you might have noted: Wildlife Protection Act 1972, four types of protected areas under it, two already existed from 1972 at the starting itself, and 2003, from 2003 two more are added. So these are main points. See, so now we are going to discuss the national park. What is a national park? It is a protected area under the government. It is strictly under the government. The land is under the government. So the activity, any human activity is is secluded from it. No human interference is allowed in a national park. See, activities like grazing, forestry are not permitted in these areas. See, this national park, who declares it, is also important from your prelims point of view. The state government has the authority under the Wildlife Protection Act to declare a particular region that is owned by it. If it considers it to be of immense ecological importance, then it can declare it as national park. So once it is declared as national park, all the human activities are prohibited from this area, are banned from this area. One chief feature of national park is that it is not solely focused on protection of vulnerable species. See friends, when we will be discussing wildlife sanctuaries, we will notice that the wildlife sanctuaries are for the purpose of protecting faunal species, that is animal species. But in case of national park, the scope is wider. It not only focuses on the faunal species, but it also focuses on the flora, that is plant species, as well as the natural landscape and historic objects of that particular area. So in scope, we can say that national park has a wider scope than the wildlife sanctuaries. And also the human activity I have already explained to you, and entry there is completely prohibited. In national parks, you can't enter. There are certain categories of individuals that can enter there. Others have to take permit. They can't enter there without the permit. So also if you want to do and undertake any activity, you must have the permit there. In that sense, you must take permit from the appropriate authority. Who is the appropriate authority who will grant you the permit to enter there? That is the chief wildlife warden. So friends, please important, this is important, please notice this authority. This chief wildlife warden is the main responsible authority for managing, controlling and sustaining the national park. So all the permits that you need to go into national parks is granted by this individual. So next is wildlife sanctuary. See friends, wildlife sanctuary is also declared under Wildlife Protection Act 1972, and that it is also declared by state government. But the chief feature of wildlife sanctuary is that it may or may not be for a particular species. It may be declared for a particular species. So as I have told you, national parks, they are not for a particular species. Wildlife sanctuaries can or cannot be for a particular species, but they are primarily concerned with the faunal species, that is protecting animal species. See, human activities like grazing here are permitted, but it is not completely prohibited. It is permitted there, but it is regulated. Why it is regulated? Because this human activity should be allowed to the extent that it does not interfere with the natural processes within the sanctuary. So you can go there, you can practice your grazing and all these activities, but to a limited extent. You are permitted to a limited extent, so long as you are not disturbing the biological and natural processes there within the sanctuary. So here also the chief wildlife warden is the managing and controlling authority. So in terms of protected areas, that is national parks and wildlife sanctuary, the chief managing and controlling authority is chief wildlife warden. So activities here are permitted. All the regulation is done by chief wildlife warden. If you want to go there, undertake certain activities like research or studying the wildlife, then you have to apply for the permit that is granted by chief wildlife warden. Next comes, friends, conservation reserve. So as I have told you in previous slides, that in 1972 the Wildlife Protection Act came, in which there was a provision for declaring certain regions of immense ecological importance as protected areas like national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. So earlier there were only two categories, that is national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. However, in 2003 an amendment was passed to this Wildlife Protection Act by which it was provided that certain areas can also be declared as community reserves or conservation reserves. So what is the purpose of declaring these areas as conservation reserves or community reserves? The particular purpose is to provide recognition, as well as legal backing to the community initiated efforts to conserve biodiversity. See friends, certain communities by themselves volunteer to conserve the wildlife surroundings in the areas they reside in and around the areas they reside. So in order to provide them recognition as well as legal backing, this amendment was moved. So it is a flexible mechanism which balances also the community needs as well as the wildlife conservation. So it is a kind of a reconciliation between development as well as the conservation of nature. So who declares conservation reserves? Friends, conservation reserves are also declared by the state government, but they are declared, the point to be noted here is they are declared only in that area which is owned by state government and it is adjacent to national parks or wildlife sanctuaries. So it is not declared on private land. See, who manages these conservation reserves? The conservation reserves are managed by Conservation Reserve Management Committee. फ्रेंड्स प्लीज नोटिस दिस पॉइंट, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम योर प्रीलिम्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. द तिरुपदई मराथुर कंजर्वेशन रिजर्व इन तिरुनवेली तमिलनाडु हैज बीन डिक्लेयर द फर्स्ट कंजर्वेशन रिजर्व इन इंडिया. प्लीज नोट दिस पॉइंट. एंड नेक्स्ट कम्स द कम्युनिटी रिजर्व. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो एडेड बाई द अमेंडमेंट ऑफ 2003 टू द वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट 1972. इट इज ऑल्सो डिक्लेयर्ड बाई स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. कम्युनिटी रिजर्व इज ऑल्सो डिक्लेयर्ड बाई स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, बट इट कैन बी डिक्लेयर्ड इन एनी कम्युनिटी और प्राइवेट लैंड. इट कैन ऑल्सो भी डिक्लेयर्ड ऑन प्राइवेट लैंड, प्रोवाइडेड द कंडीशन इज दैट द मेंबर्स ऑफ द कम्युनिटी मस्ट हैव वॉलंटियर्ड फॉर दिस. इट इज नॉट दैट स्टेट गवर्नमेंट बाई इटसेल्फ कैन डिक्लेयर एनी एरिया एज अ कम्युनिटी रिजर्व. द कंडीशन इज दैट द कम्युनिटी रिजर्व मस्ट द कम्युनिटी कंसर्न्ड इन दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया मस्ट कम फॉरवर्ड एंड इट मस्ट volunteer to safeguard the environment and safeguard the wildlife residing there. So if they have volunteered, the state government can take notice and can declare that area as community reserve. So basically, who manages the community reserve? The community reserve is managed by community reserve management committee. In case of land use, friends, the pattern of land use is not altered there. If you want to alter the pattern of land use, it must be by a resolution that is passed by the management committee, that is community reserve management committee, and that resolution will not suffice. This resolution must also be approved by the state government. Then only you can change the land use pattern there. So already we have covered the lecture. We have covered the protected area network that are declared for conserving the wildlife and flora and fauna. And in protected area network, we have done the national initiatives that are undertaken by India to safeguard its wildlife. So in these national initiatives are covered under Wildlife Protection Act. So four types of categories I have explained to you: national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, community reserves, and conservation reserves. So these are national initiatives. In next lecture, we will be going to cover the global initiative to conserve biodiversity. That is the biosphere reserves under the Man and Biosphere Program. This is also a very important topic for your prelims as well as from your prelims points of view as well as mains point of view. We will cover it in next lecture. So friends, if you have liked my video, please if you liked my video, please share it. Please give me suggestions if in any way I can improve my way of teaching. I will certainly appreciate your viewpoint. Thank you friends, thank you very much.